name is Stacey Flowers, and I'm a student of Dave Ramsey's Financial Peace University and on a journey to become 100% debt-free. I am currently on baby step number one to save $500, and that is because my income is under $20,000 a year. I work part-time, earning anywhere from $1,000 to $1,200 a month. I have over $180,000 worth of debt, and in this video, I'm going to be talking about the four walls in great detail. So if you are interested in learning exactly what Dave Ramsey's four walls are and how I was able to secure my four walls, please keep watching. Okay, so this is something that if anyone has ever taken Financial Peace University, but also if you've been following me for a while, you hear me talk about over and over and over again, and that is the four walls. And last week I did a video where I talked about baby step zero. Inside of baby step zero, there is a task to secure your four walls. And I started to talk about it a little bit in that video, but I realized that this particular step is so massive and significant and important when it comes to paying off debt that it was worth its own separate video, so that way it was easier for you all to be able to refer to it if ever you felt like your four walls weren't secure and you wanted to make sure that you could get them to that point. What the four walls are in its most basic terms is you getting current on all of your most immediate expenses and things that you need to survive, excluding debts. And a lot of people get their four walls confused because they actually include their debt inside of their four walls, but their four walls is something totally different than their actual debt. And I want to remind you, Dave Ramsey's Financial Peace University is a radical debt elimination and financial management plan. The emphasis is on radical because there are a lot of radical things and countercultural things that he would ask for you to do and ways that he would have you to organize expenses so that way you can eliminate debt forever and live the rest of your life by cash. And so in that, even when you're thinking about the four walls, you may have to shift your paradigm just a little bit because a lot of people include their debts inside of their basic necessities. For Dave Ramsey, it's not included. What's included in your four walls in this order are number one, food. Food is your number one priority, and the way that he sort of talks about it in his book, The Total Money Makeover, as well as in his program, is that your food is your fuel. It's literally the thing that gives you the energy to be able to go out and earn money. And the whole point about the four walls isn't necessarily to make you feel better about your financial situation. It's really to secure you so that you can go out and make more income so that way you can overcome whatever financial crisis you may be experiencing right now. That's the number one thing, is that you want to figure out what it costs for you to eat. This is not a license for you to decide that you're going to, it's a necessity for you to go out to eat. He actually encourages you to do a beans and rice diet and a lot of cooking for scratch. And I have adopted both of those philosophies. And I will tell you, from a health perspective and also just from a like feminine woman excited to be in the kitchen perspective, cooking for scratch is a total delight. And then eating beans and rice, if you take the time to make things in your crock pot and just really figure out flavors that you like, it can actually be very delicious as well as nutritious, right? The second thing that he tells you to secure is your utilities. He suggests that you get current on all of your utility bills because it's actually a hazard to your health and well-being, as well as your children or spouses, if anyone else is living in the home, for you to be in a shelter, but for you to not have running water or lights. It actually prevents you from being able to be hygienic. It prevents you from being able to maintain a measure of health. And so often people will be in their homes with their lights or their heat off, and they won't be honest enough with themselves to admit that they are in a state of crisis because they still have a roof over their head. And according to Dave Ramsey's four walls, it's like that roof over your head is a part of it, but your utilities being on is a major emphasis in the part of having a roof over your head. The other categories that fall into utilities that people tend to put in there are like their cable bill, their phone bill, and a lot of their internet bills, expenses that are associated with that. And technically those are utility terms, or utility expenses, but inside of your four walls, your utilities are those basic necessities that allow you to be able to live in your home in a way that supports you being healthy. And that is, for some people, electric, gas, and water. For some, it'll be one. For others, it'll be three. But the idea is that you want to become current on all of those expenses in order for your four walls to actually be secure. The third thing that he talks about in these four walls and he suggests that you secure is your shelter. And that could be if you are renting or if you have a mortgage. And a good example that comes up often, if you ever listen to his show on iHeartRadio or on his website at www.daveramsey.com, is that people will be behind mortgage, but they'll be on baby step one and they'll have like an emergency fund. And so what he always says is that, like, if you're behind on your mortgage, you are in a state of emergency. So whatever you have in your emergency fund should be used to get you caught up on your mortgage. It's the same thing if you're renting. If you're behind on your rent, it should be used to get you caught up on your rent. And I talk a lot about like rent versus being on time versus being current. I am current with my rent, which means right now we are in the month of April, and I believe this is the fifth day. I don't know what today is, but we are in the month of April at the beginning of the week, and my rent for this month has already been paid. Now, a lot of people, because they have that bonus March check, they are behind on their rent because they are waiting until their first check in April, which tends to come around that 15th to 18th date, to pay their rent. And they're willing to pay their rent with a $50 late fee. That is an obvious state of being behind on your rent. But there's another state of being behind on your rent, which is when you're right on time. And what that means is that a lot of renting places will give you from the 1st to the 5th to be able to pay your rent. And typically when our people who are in a state of crisis with their finances, instead of paying their rent on or before the 1st, they will take the 5-day grace period and they will live in a place for 5 days rent-free, essentially. And they will do that perpetually, month to month to month. They're on time because they're not late, but you're not current because you have given yourself that 5-day grace. And technically for 5 days, you are living rent-free. And it's just not a healthy financial, it's just not a healthy way to manage your finances in terms of you using the grace as the time frame for you to be on time. The current on your rent is when you pay your rent before the month begins, so that way you are always living in a space that is paid for, as opposed to trying to get everything taken care of by the 5th and essentially having those 5 days grace. And what you will find is that this particular habit of using the grace, you use that not just on your rent, but you probably use it on your credit cards, you probably use it on all of your other bills. And what happens is you feel perpetually behind, and you are, because during that grace you have not paid for anything. And whether you want to say it's a psychological thing, it's emotional thing, the fact of the matter is the truth is you have not paid, and you will perpetuate, like, the feeling of being behind will be something that you can't escape because you are on time but you are not current. And so what he suggests is that you become current on all of your expenses. And your next category in your four walls is transportation. And specifically, when you're looking up at transportation, he's intending for you to see transportation as a means to get you to work so that you can earn an income. He's not considering transportation from the perspective of, this is my dream car and I want this, or he's not considering transportation from the perspective of, you know, can I afford the monthly payments? What he's literally saying is that you need to know how you are going to get back and forth to work, and the costs that are associated with that needs to be secured and built into your four walls. And so when I first started this journey, I had a car. Eventually my car was repossessed. I went into taking public transportation. I'm very blessed to live in a city where public transportation is in abundance, and I love it. The last couple of weeks I've elected to walk just to save a little bit of money there. But inside of my budget, there is a $100 cost built in for transportation. And that transportation cost enables me to get back and forth to work. And so what Dave Ramsey suggests is that you secure your transportation, because if you don't, you're not going to be able to get back and forth to work. And if you can't get back and forth to work, then you can't earn an income. If you can't earn an income, you can't get out of your financial crisis. So that is why transportation is a part of your four walls. The fifth and final category that's a part of your four walls are clothing. And a lot there, this produces so many issues for people, because people are like, you know, you shouldn't be buying clothes if you have all this debt, or you shouldn't be buying clothes if you know, you're behind on your mortgage, or you shouldn't, like, there's so many opinions about this clothing category. And so here are the caveats to clothing. He's not saying that you should have a decked out wardrobe. He's not suggesting that you maintain your designer bag habit. What he's suggesting is that you have enough clothes to be able to wear back and forth to work. So if you work in an office building and professional attire is required, what Dave Ramsey is suggesting that you do is take a portion of your income while you're trying to secure your four walls and go buy a few suits so you can dress appropriately when you go into work to earn your money. What he's not suggesting that you do is just disregard the fact that you work in a professional environment and wear clothes that are not appropriate, because what's going to happen is you're going to lose the income that's associated with that job if you don't show up dressed the way that that job is suggesting that you dress based on their dress code. I'm hoping that that makes sense, because so many people like get up in arms about people's clothing budget being a part of their four walls. But if you think about it, you need clothes to be able to wear to work. Some people work in a place where they wear a uniform. At my current part-time job, I have a uniform, but there are certain shoes and there are certain just like cleanliness, like there's some slacks that we can't wear. So I had to make sure that I had those items so that that way I could go to work. And for some people, you have to pay for your uniform. So that would be added to your clothing budget. But in addition to me working part-time, I show up on this camera, I'm a professional speaker, so I show up on stage. So there's a little bit more clothing needs that I have than the average person doesn't have. Now, does this mean I'm going crazy? No, but it does mean that if I book a speaking engagement and I have to go on stage, I have something that I can wear to go and work to earn more money so that that way I can secure my four walls and get started on paying my debt. So those are the four walls. It's really five categories, but those are the four walls and those are the bare necessities. And that is the order in which he suggests that you secure the necessities. And that's intentional because each necessity builds on the next. Once you secure your food, it's easier for you to think about taking care of those utilities. Once you've taken care of your utilities, then you can manage your mortgage or your rent better. Once your rent and your mortgage is managed, then you can handle a transportation cost. And last but certainly not least, once transportation is in order, you can handle your clothing budget and adding those different things to your life. Now for me personally, how I was able to take care of my four walls, the number one thing, again, I took care of my food. I figured out, I worked really hard to try to get myself on a $30 a month budget, didn't work, was able to get me to about $50. Once I knew that I could eat well for $50 a month, it freed up much more money in my budget for me to be able to put in other categories. My utilities and my rent are all lumped into one, but what I did initially, because the place that I'm in now is a two bedroom, two bath, Chicago, Bronzeville apartment, and my monthly rent, I think, was $1,050. That was too much for me to be paying at the time. And so I asked the person who I was renting from if she could help me to find a roommate or someone to take over the other room temporarily so that I could cut those costs in half. She was able to do that. So then my rent and utility bundle went down to $525. I did that intentionally. I could have elected to keep my rent at $1,000 and pushed out the work to be able to earn to be able to cover that. But to secure my four walls, to get current on my rent, current in all these other categories, I elected to have a roommate temporarily so that that way I could get ahead and get in front of all of these expenses that were coming out. In terms of my transportation, I also made the decision to allow my car, which came with a monthly car note and car insurance. And it's interesting because at the time when it was getting repossessed, I would have also had to renew my tags. But all of the expenses that are associated with that, I no longer have those expenses. Do I have a ding on my credit? Yes. Do I have an expense left over from the auction sale of my car through the bank that I was given the loan through? Yes. But I rather manage that debt than try to manage a monthly car note, car insurance, and replating my car. And so once I was able to change that debt, change that car debt, then I went into, okay, how am I going to get back and forth to work? And I was able to secure that with a $100 bus pass. And so once I secure my transportation, it left the fifth and final category, and that was for me to secure a little bit of clothing. And I elected to use the capsule wardrobe philosophy so that that way I can get the most bang for my buck in terms of being able to take a few number of pieces and use them in multiple ways so that that way I wouldn't feel like I didn't have stuff to wear every single day and I had to live this bland, styleless life. Like, the capsule wardrobe enables me to rotate several pieces over and over and over again that totally spark joy and enable me to have enough in my wardrobe to be able to show up on camera and go to work at my part-time job. And in me doing that, my four walls have been secure. And you guys have seen, now that my four walls are secure, I'm paying a little bit on my debt. I've made a decision to move. I'm able to make better decisions financially and emotionally for myself now that my four walls have been secured. And so my hope is that in you all watching this video and also hearing about some of the decisions that I made so that I could actually secure my four walls, that it inspires you to secure your four walls. If you are in FPU or you are in any other financial management program, I highly encourage you to adopt the four walls concept and get your food budget in order. Figure out what it truly costs for you to be able to eat well a month. Then after you do that, get your utilities in order, get your rent in order, put yourself in a position to be able to get current on your rent and not just on time. Then after that, do what you have to do for transportations. For some people, that could be selling your car. For some people, that could be buying a smaller beater car. For some people, that could be going as extreme as I did, which I don't necessarily recommend it. If you don't have the mental capacity to be able to handle that, don't do that. But doing what you need to do to be able to secure your transportation, followed by getting a little bit of clothing in order so that that way you can show up for the life that you are trying to build. One that is 100% debt-free and enables you to be able to live by cash. So that is all that I have for you guys today. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Until the next video, I deeply appreciate your support. I am so grateful to every single one of you who comments, who likes, who shares, who watches. Thank you so very much. I will talk to you all very soon.